Ahead on JAG TV, the local news is here at South.
Also, South students take over the Ozarks in New Orleans over spring break. We have full details.
And the madness has hit South High School. We'll tell you why.
All these stories and more coming up. JAG TV starts right now.
You're
watching
JAG TV.
Hi, you're watching JAG TV and me, Lane Phillips, just got all sweat.
Hey guys, and welcome back to this week's JAG TV.
We all hope you had a great spring break.
This past Monday, one senior received a scholarship right here at South.
Here's Taylor Burton standing by South Zone Tennis Courts. Taylor?
Thanks guys. This past Monday, KMBC News came to honor South's own senior, Stephanie Adams. KMBC and the Hy-Vee awarded Stephanie with a $1,000 scholarship for being a scholar athlete. We had a chance to speak with Stephanie to see what she thought of the honor.
Well, I was very surprised I got the scholarship because I knew I was going against a lot of really well-qualified applicants and everything, but it was really fun. It was really exciting and everything, and the people were so nice, so it was really nice to work with them, and it was just very surprising, but definitely very honored by that.
In other sports news, the baseball team is off to a solid start with a 2-1 record. The next baseball game is at Liberty, March 28th at 5 o'clock. That's it for this week's sports. Back to you guys.
This past week, South Senators traveled to New Orleans, Louisiana to pay a visit to their cross-country pen pals.
Here's Brandon with more on the story.
Thanks, guys. Senate took time out of their busy lives over spring break to take a trip to New Orleans in efforts of bringing hope to students who have seen and been through the devastation of Hurricane Katrina.
My daughter teaches in New Orleans. She's been down there for the past year and a half, and we have been pen pals with her students down there, so it was an opportunity for us to meet them. We spent 3 days in the school with our pen pals. We are helping them get ready for a state test. In Louisiana, you have to pass a test at the end of your eighth grade year to be able to go on to high school. To visit the Ninth Ward, which everyone's heard about because of Katrina, which I think was really eye-opening for the kids.
Thinking about all that we take for granted, then one day losing it all. We live in a world run so much by routine, being thrown out into the unknown with nothing but a car full of survivals and a broken heart. Knowing you lost all that you once gained is our worst nightmare. Looking at the lives that they left, many people picked up and started all over somewhere else, leaving what they once called home now as a pile of junk. Yes, some have come back and some have rebuilt, but Hurricane Katrina's effects will last for many years to come with the lives it destroyed, the hearts it shattered, and the dreams it crushed. New Orleans may never be the same. But with each and every volunteer's help, one day at a time, they get one step closer to normal. Through all odds and doubts, with the help of people like you, they are reclaiming their city, one service project at a time, one building at a time, one student at a time, one life at a time. It takes a village to save one life, but only one life to make a difference. I'm Brandon Nelson, reporting for JAG TV. Back to you guys.
Also during spring break, Blue Spring South DECA traveled to their annual State Career Development Conference at the Lake of the Ozarks March 13th through the 15th. They had a total of 22 students compete at the conference, with four South seniors, including Nick Strope, Emily Miranda, Meredith Curd, and Carlin Killebrew, qualify for the International Career and Development Conference held next month in Orlando, Florida. Congratulations to you four and good luck.
With all the reconstruction at South, have you checked out the newly remodeled JAG Den recently? Here's JAG TV's Olivia Lucas with more.
Come to the JAG Den. It's open before school, 7:05 to 7:20, and also during past period, going to lunch.
The JAG Den is open every morning from 7:05 to 7:20 and in between every lunch shift. They sell food, drinks, school supplies, and South Spirit Wear. And for all of you guys who didn't even know we had a school store, here's Jessica Kennedy showing you where it is.
I'll show you where the den is. Ta-da! No more confusion.
Jaguar for life.
Now here's this week's South announcements. Seniors interested in designing the senior t-shirts and senior breakfast programs, There's a $25 prize award to the winner. Visit the Counseling Center office for more information. And also, tickets for Mr. Jaguar on sale in the Commons for $6 and at the door for $10. Lastly, if you're interested in summer school, forms can be picked up in the Counseling's office.
Antonique, have you noticed the madness here at South lately?
Yes, actually I have, with all this talk about bracketology.
Here's Jesse Howe with more.
Hey guys, it's March, which means March Madness. I know you're about halfway through March, but we decided to go see everything about bracketology and how everyone's brackets are doing.
No, I think Duke's going to win everything.
Kansas.
BYU's going to win.
Who's going to win?
Ohio State.
Of course, picking the right teams to win is easier said than done. There were 64 teams that entered last year in 32 different games, and to guess which one would win, these were your chances. You actually have a better chance of playing Russian roulette half a dozen times and winning. But if the stakes are too high for you, you could always enter a Quidditch bracket for Hogwarts.
Stay tuned next week to see a sneak peek about Mr. Jaguar and the dangers of texting and driving.
Now for the latest Blue Spring South news, check out our website, jagtvnews.net. There you can click on the As Seen on TV link and read about these stories and more.
Thank you for watching this week's JAG TV on Comcast Channel 15 and AT&T UVerse Channel 99.
Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time on JAG TV.